Hi everyone, welcome to Mount Pleasant Online. Whether it is your 50th time joining us or your first time joining us, you are so welcome. We are so happy that you are here. And I hope you've had a great week, whatever it's held for you. It is officially December, and so I think that means that we can be unashamed by all things festive and joyful and merry. And so I hope that your lives are slowly filling up with all things Christmas. Speaking of, we have a little video today to let you know of some of the things we've got going on for Christmas for you. We've also got worship from our amazing worship team who have been providing us with just like deep breath moments all this year. They've been insane. And we've got Mike Taylor from Newport giving us a word, and he was always filled with encouragement and challenge all mixed into one amazing time. So today's gonna be a good one, I think. But before any of that, I'm just gonna pray. I'm gonna pray over you, over me, over this time, over it all. Because more than anything, this morning or this afternoon or this evening or whenever you're watching this, we just want this to be a time where you can breathe deeply. We want this to be a time where you can just chill in the presence of God, have a cup of tea in the presence of God. That is what this is all about. And so I'm just going to pray that over you, if that's okay, if you want to join me. So God, we just thank you that no pandemic can get in your way, that just because we can't be in the same room together, you are in every room that we are in. You are Emmanuel, you are God with us. And I just thank you that that is who you are. And that is who you've been through this whole year. And that is who you will always be, God in the same place at the same time as us. And so right now, for this next, however long we're together, even if it is digitally, would you just fill every single space where this is being watched? Would you overwhelm the stuff that has been overwhelming us up until this point? Would you dim all of the distractions and all of the worries and everything else that has been filling our minds recently? Would you just dim it all, and would you come in and remind us who you are in the midst of it? Would you come in and bring peace, bring tranquility, bring joy, bring comfort? Would you come in and just remind us who you are this December, who you always have been and who you always will be? Amen. Hi guys! So we know that this Christmas is not quite going to be what you hoped or planned for it to be, but it is by no means cancelled either. As a church, we're obviously not going to be able to be in the same room this year, but that will not stop us. As has been the 2020 way, we are going to be bringing all of the Christmas joy straight to your living rooms. So let me hand over to a few amazing people who are going to tell you a little more about the festivities we have got going online for you this December.
Worship Wednesdays has been one of our favourite parts of online church. We have loved bringing you that midweek breather. So keep an eye on Instagram and Facebook through December when our Worship Wednesdays are going to take on a Christmas twist. All our favourite Christmas carols, our favourite Christmas songs, put together by our worship team. We look forward to seeing you there.
So I'm here to tell you about what's going on for our little soldiers this Christmas. One being a bake-along and two being Zoom sessions every Sunday for the next 3 weeks. Watch out for more information coming up on our Facebook page.
We have two online celebrations that we would love to see you at. Firstly, on the 20th of December, we have a Christmas service and nativity play put on by some of our amazing little ones. You can watch this anytime that suits you and your family over on our YouTube channel. Then, premiering on Wednesday the 23rd of December at 7:30 p.m, we have our contemporary carol experience put together by our worship team here at Mount Pleasant. This is also on our YouTube channel, so grab your Christmassy drinks, gather your family and join us there. All the festivities from the comfort of your sofa.
So come and join us all the way through this December as we celebrate a Christmas like no other in history, as we fix our eyes on our thrill of hope. We can't wait to see you there.
God. God so loved that he gave his son to lay down his life for the sake of us. He bore the weight of our sin and shame. With a cry he said, it is finished. Christ the Lord overcame the darkness. He's alive, death has been defeated. For he made us a way by which we have been saved. He's the Saviour of the world. So we lift up a shout for his fame and renown. Praise the Lord, Jesus, Saviour of the world. Saviour of the world. We must spread the word of his soon return to reclaim the world for his glory. Church now sing of his coming King, crowned with majesty, our Redeemer. And he reigns, ruler of the heavens, and his name is Jesus the Messiah. For he made us a way by which we have been saved. Saviour of the world. So we lift up a shout for his fame and renown. Praise the Lord, Jesus, Saviour of the world. For he made us a way by which we have been saved. He's the Saviour of the world. So we for his name and renown. Praise the Lord, Jesus, Saviour of the world. Saviour of the world. Christ the Lord overcame the darkness. He's alive. Has been defeated, and he reigns, ruler of the heavens, and his name is Jesus the Messiah. For he made us a way by which we have been saved. He's the Saviour of the world. So we lift up a shout for his fame and renown. Praise the Lord, Jesus, Saviour of the world. For he made us a way by which we have been saved. He's the Saviour of the world. So we lift up a shout for his fame and renown. Praise the Lord, Jesus, Saviour of the world. Saviour of the world. Hallelujah. Be high and lifted up. Be high and lifted up. Be high and lifted up. Jesus, it's you we glorify. It's you we're lifting high. Your name be glorified. Be high and lifted up. Be high and lifted up. Be high and lifted up. Jesus, it's you we glorify. It's you we're lifting high. Your name be glorified.
Name of Jesus Christ, my King. Hi guys, Pastor Mike here. I hope you're all well and Merry Christmas. We've just put our Christmas decorations up here in church, and I'll be putting them up this weekend at home. So I just pray that you're all well and getting through this crazy season. I just want to really encourage you and say you're doing such a phenomenal job with your online church. I've watched it several times and really enjoyed it. So yeah, well done to your media team and all your team that's putting that together. I just want to share a message with you that God gave me a few weeks ago. And I feel that it's a prophetic message for us as the Church of Wales, not just for my church and Faith Church, but for us as a church across a nation. I believe that God wants to do something significant in us as individuals and in us as a church. So I just pray that you are challenged and you are blessed by what I have to say.
Around the things that I've been thinking around Pentecost and church and the season that we find ourselves in. And, you know, when we look at church and what's going on and the changes, there's, especially in different parts of the world, there's a lot of people that are trying to portray that the government are against what we believe. I just want to assure you as a pastor here in the UK, the government isn't against Christians, but we're just living in interesting times where we have to adhere to what the government says. And it's quite interesting, you know, that Jesus faced this same challenge when he was on the earth. And in Matthew 22:21, they're talking to him about whether he should pay taxes and who he should pay it to. And it's a lot more deeper than that, because the Roman Empire and Caesar was seen as a god and all that. They were trying to catch him. And he makes this very interesting statement. He says, Jesus says, render to Caesar the things that are Caesar's and to God the things that are God's. And, you know, about that, there has to be this respect for the societies, the governmental processes that we live within. And Romans 13:1 says, let every person be subject to the governing authorities, because they're put there by God. And you know, we're so blessed in the UK that we have such freedoms. And as we navigate through this season of this global pandemic, the government are going to give us different frameworks on which we can paint church on. And when I was praying and with Pat Sparrow and John and the church over there in California in the week, and I just had this picture of that God says, don't worry, the government will give you canvases, but I will give you a painting of church to put on them. You know, I'm a Bristolian. That's why he talks proper like a pirate. Only joking. But I'm from Bristol, and Bristol has a really famous graffiti artist called Banksy, and he's probably the only graffiti artist that probably most people know about. And when Banksy paints one of his masterpieces on a wall, he doesn't ask the wall to change. He looks at the wall and says, what can I create with this space? He did an amazing painting a good couple of months ago down in Port Talbot about the pollution. And so he doesn't ask for the wall to change. He just looks at it and says, I can paint something. And that's the prophetic picture that I have for us as the church here in Wales, in the UK, is whatever Boris decides, whatever structure he puts around us, we have such an opportunity to paint such a beautiful picture of Jesus's church on that canvas. And you know, when we think about Pentecost was the birth of what we would call the church. It's when Jesus had gone back to heaven and he sent them to the upper room to wait for his Holy Spirit to come. And there were the disciples and a group of his followers, basically in fear, hiding away in an upper room, not knowing what was going to happen, because it hadn't quite panned out what they thought, but still believing in Jesus and waiting for their moment of power to come. And as the people from my church read earlier, the Holy Spirit falls on them and they speak in tongues, and they become filled with this heavenly power called the Holy Spirit. And it says that he says on that day that they were together in one place. You know, The church at the moment, you know, we might not be physically in one place, but I feel by my spirit we are more together than what we were when we met in a building, that we are having to put effort into our connections. And there's a unity here within Faith Church, and I pray that it's the same for other churches across Wales and across the UK. And I believe that, you know, God wants to fill that unity with his presence, through with his power, Holy Spirit. You know, he wants his church in this season to be a shining light of reverent respect for the government, but a portraying a church of power and authority and love and grace in this season. And you know, God commands unity before he's able to pull that out, because he's not going to pull that out on a church that's going off in different places and different things. And you know, I think it's really important in this season that we prioritize extra effort, the coming together of one another, you know, that we make the effort to connect in online and those things, and to draw people into those connections. You know, we all have a choice to be in unity or not to be in unity. And I think so often we've looked at the picture when it comes to church is, I will unify myself with church if the church is what I want it to be. We need to scrap that mentality. That's not true. You know, the church is the church, and we have to see that God will put us into situations where he wants to join us to a body and to be unified with our body, so that we can be one of the cogs in the thing called church. You know, Paul talks about one body, many different limbs. You know, God wants us to come in and not come with what we have in our Western mentality of, oh, I'll join it if they got a good worship team, I'll join it if they've got this, I'll join it if they got that. What would it look like if we say, God, where do you want me to put myself? I want to serve you. I want to be unified with your church. Where would you want me to plant myself? And God may send you to the not the most perfect church. He may send you to somewhere that doesn't meet all your needs. But if it's a God thing, his Holy Spirit will dwell in that place and you will be empowered. You know, another thing that you know, that I think a trap that we've fallen into in the Western church is we have our upper room experiences, but we never walk down the stairs. You know, we can gather and we can have these great moments of in praise and worship where we feel the tangible presence of his Holy Spirit, and people fall on the floor and, you know, oh, we all cry and we're like, yeah, God is amazing. And then we go home. You know what? The biggest miracle in Pentecost, I think, is that they got filled with the Holy Spirit. Then they walked down the stairs from the upper room and preached the gospel, and 4,000 people got saved. You know, when the Holy Spirit didn't come so churches can have hyped up spiritual meetings, he came so that we could be empowered to go out and perform miracles on the streets of Wales. He empowered us so that we can ring up our friends and ask God to guide us through those conversations, so that we can bring prophetic words of revelation and comfort to them. Not for us to hide away in some holy huddle in a well-performed, smoke-hazed-filled church which doesn't touch the rawness of humanity. You know, the Holy Spirit needs to make us bold. It needs to make us courageous. It needs us... The Holy Spirit should cause you not to walk away from those God-given opportunities, even though how scary they might seem. I remember when I was a young teenager and I'd left home, and I said to God, I'll do whatever you ask me. And I just got a job at this sailing centre. I think it was my first week there, and a school group had come, and the coach driver got off the coach and he had a plaster on his arm, and all the kids went into the sailing center, and God said, you need to pray that arm gets healed. And I was like, God, it's like my first week. You know, I'm just going to look so stupid. And he's like, well, you told me that you wanted to serve me. So I walked over to the guy and I said, look, this is a Christian sailing center. I'm a Christian, and I believe God can heal people. And he's like, oh, right. I said, can I just pray for your arm, please? I said, I just really feel that God wants to knit that bone back together quickly. And I think he said yes to kind of get rid of me. So I prayed, simple prayer, God heal his arm in the name of Jesus, amen. I don't think it was any more than that. And quickly scurried my way back out of the way, not to be too embarrassed by what happened. Comes back a week later, and same coach driver without a plaster on his arm. He said, went back to the orthopedic specialist, and he said that my arm had healed far quicker than anybody expected. And he said, there's something in this God thing. I said, yeah, there is. I said, it's, you know, it's what I believe in. It's what defines my life, my relationship with God. And I said, well, if you believe that's a miracle, maybe you should find a church. I don't know where he went, but there was a miracle. And I wonder how much of that we miss. You know, if we want to be filled with the Holy Spirit and we want to celebrate what Pentecost is, Pentecost and the Holy Spirit coming to earth to empower his church should have a reaction. And the reaction should be a church on fire that wants to go and preach the gospel, pray for miracles in shopping queues, in the streets, in wherever we find ourselves. Hide away in spiritual huddles in churches where we don't meet any need in society. You know, and it goes on, if you read on in the story, it says they devoted themselves to the apostles' teachings and fellowship. You know, a church which is empowered by the Holy Spirit should be constantly replicating itself. You know, and let me tell you, this is my take on discipleship. Discipleship always comes out of relationship. Otherwise, we become a dictatorship. You know, it doesn't matter how much I scream Bible verses at you, you're never going to learn unless I have a relationship with you. And the one thing that empowers me to form relationships quicker than anything else is the Holy Spirit. I say, God, Holy Spirit, be in this. And I've formed relationships with people that... probably if I wasn't a Christian, I would never connect with them, because it's through the power of the Holy Spirit that I find connection. Then I'm able to share the gospel message that I carry. I'm able to open up my Bible and unpack the things that are in there. But it comes through relationships empowered by the Holy Spirit. You know, so if you feel you're called to discipleship, you need to pray that you have the Holy Spirit on board, and you need to pray that you can quickly form depths of relationships with people so that you can disciple them. I just encourage you, you know, to press in. You know, what a great opportunity we have today. You know, I want to challenge you. When was the last time that you just went out on a walk on your own and you just said, Holy Spirit, you know, you're welcome here. I love that song. You know, it's simple. Holy Spirit, you're welcome here. That's all it takes. You know, confess your sins. Jesus, forgive me of my sins. Forgive me the things I know I did and the things I didn't know I did. And Holy Spirit, come and dwell in me. Empower me to be the person you want me to be. What would it look like if we all made that our prayer? I think the church would radically change. I think society would change, because there would be people that would be slow to anger, quick to bring peace, quick to speak out and see miracles come through the words of prayers of faith that they bring. You know, that Wales would be a different place. And you know, I was given a prophetic word several years ago about Wales singing again, and I was reminded by my good friend Malcolm Morgan this week that this is the season for Wales to sing. But I don't want us to sing Bread of Heaven because it's a cool song, or Love as Vast as the Ocean, because I want to sing it empowered by the Holy Spirit. So there's the essence of his voice coming through what we sing, that when people hear us sing it, lives are just transformed. And we have our moment when we come down from the upper room and we go out and face the world and we see thousands get saved. You know, I don't strive for that. I have a passion to see that happen in my world, in my nation, in a genuine, real way. It started 2,000 years ago when the disciples, full of fear, waited on God. And we just need to wait on God and expect his Holy Spirit to inhabit all of who we are, and then to act. Because through activation, the Holy Spirit becomes real to the world that we live in, and we see revival break out in our nation. I'm just going to pray. It doesn't matter where you are in the world. It doesn't matter whether you're on a mountaintop, sat in your living room, wherever it is right now. If I pray, I believe that the Holy Spirit can come into your life. If you've never been a Christian before, this is about you saying, Jesus, I want you to be in charge of my life. I want to turn my life to you. I want to invite your presence into my life. And I trust that you're real and I want to discover who you are. If you're a Christian and your faith has become dry and weary right now, as I pray that the Holy Spirit would come into you and freshen your relationship with him, that would bring life to it. So wherever you are, just close your eyes, chuck the dog out, chuck the cat out, just have a quiet moment. And I'm going to pray and I'm going to believe by faith that the Holy Spirit is going to minister to us across the world. Yeah, Holy Spirit, we sit here as those disciples did in the upper room in a situation where the future isn't so clear right now, where there's lots of uncertainties and all those kind of things. But we just acknowledge that you are our comforter. We acknowledge that you are the thing that brings power to our faith. And we just invite you, Holy Spirit, into every situation right now, Lord. I pray specifically right now for anybody that's listening to me that has drug addictions or any addictions. I pray right now that your Holy Spirit minister into their lives, that they would find freedom in this moment as they turn to you. And Lord, I pray where there's lonely people out there right now that have been in isolation for a while or have separated from loved ones or have lost loved ones, I pray right now by the power of your Holy Spirit that you bring comfort to those situations. And Lord, I pray right now where there's people tuning in just because they want to find answers, I pray that they would meet you, they would meet Jesus head on in this moment and they would find their Saviour. And Lord, I pray for people right now that are maybe on ventilators, maybe really sick or have blood clots from this virus. I pray right now as they reach out to you by your miracle working power that you would turn around medical situations in people's lives. But Lord, we want your Holy Spirit to believe on us again as a Welsh nation. We want to be a nation that sings again for you. And as we sing, we see your Spirit move through our land. So we just acknowledge this morning that you are King of Kings, Lord of Lords. And I just pray, move by your transforming power through every person that's listening to me right now, in the name of Jesus.
Darkness, open my eyes, let me see. Yeah.
time together today has been everything that you needed it to be and more. I'm hoping that it's everything you need to fill you up for the week ahead, whatever that may hold for you. If there is anything at all that we as a church, that we as Mount Pleasant can do for you this December, please do not hesitate to get in contact with us, whether that be through our Facebook, our Instagram, our website, our email, or all of the above. Please do get in contact if we can be of any help in any way. I'm just gonna pray to round up this amazing time, and then I guess we go into the week and have a great one. So God, I just thank you for every single second of this time together. I thank you that you've used it to teach us, to encourage us, to challenge us, to strengthen us. And I just pray that sticks around for the week ahead, that stays with us, that doesn't leave us. I thank you for every word that has been spoken and sung and prayed and just everything that has flown out of today. I thank you for it, and I thank you for you. I thank you for how good you are. I thank you for how gracious you are. I thank you that you see us, that you understand us, that you know us. It's just too good to even comprehend, and yet it's just who you are. And so we give this next 7 days, this next week to you, and we pray into it, your kingdom come and your will be done in our lives as it is in heaven. Amen. Have a wonderful week.